This video covers finding simultaneous equilibrium in the goods market and the money market by combining the IS and LM curves. This leads to a method for deriving the aggregate demand curve. This model is also used to anticipate the economy's response to fiscal and monetary policy. This slide displays the goods and services market on the top right-hand side. The money market is on the left. First, in the goods market, the 45-degree line is the equilibrium condition, and the aggregate demand equation extends upward. The equilibrium interest rate and level of income are extended down to drive the IS curve. The higher interest rate results in a higher equilibrium income. Connecting these two points creates the IS curve. In the money market on the left, the real money supply is the gray vertical line. When the demand for money curve crosses it, the equilibrium interest rate is found. For a higher level of national income, Y2, the equilibrium interest rate is higher. These points create the LM curve. The intersection of the IS and LM curves denotes the equilibrium level of interest and income that will have both markets in simultaneous equilibrium. From this information, we can derive the aggregate demand curve in the price-income graph on the top right. This is done by finding the ISLM equilibrium for different price levels. Price levels are in the real money supply equation that is represented by the gray vertical bar. By drawing LM curves for different price levels, we can produce enough points in the PY space to derive the aggregate demand curve. So the LM curve is drawn down for the first price level, producing the first point at the intersection of P1 and the resulting equilibrium level of national income. A reduction in the price level increases the real money supply because people can buy more with the money they have. The lower price level shifts the money supply line outward. This causes the LM curve to shift down and the equilibrium income, Y2, to be further to the right. Where the line intersects with P2, the second point in the aggregate demand curve is drawn. This process could be repeated again to produce an even higher level of equilibrium income with lower prices. By connecting these points, the downward sloping demand curve is formed. Now for the reactions of the money market to a change in monetary policy. If the central bank increases the money supply, M, the real money supply line shifts outward and the LM curve shifts outward accordingly. Here, the LM curve is being formed for M1, a low supply of money. This forms the first point of equilibrium at I1 and Y1. When the central bank increases the money supply to M2, the LM curve shifts down. The immediate result is that the interest rate drops from its original position to the intersection of Y1 and the lower LM curve. This is based on the assumption that the money markets adjust quickly. At this point, the money market is in balance because the point is on the LM curve, but the interest rate is too low for the goods market to be in equilibrium. At this point, there is an excessive demand for goods, so output and income start to increase. The money markets adjust quickly to the increased income. An increase in income increases the demand for money and in turn increases the interest rate. This plays out as the point of equilibrium moves up the LM curve until it reaches the IS curve. At this point, the interest rate and income stabilize and the economy reaches equilibrium. So the end result of the policy of increasing the money supply lowers the interest rates and a higher level of national income results. Fiscal policy takes the form of government spending. The two red aggregate demand functions contain A bar, or exogenous demand, of which government spending is a factor. Here the IS curve is derived using the first value of exogenous demand. Equilibrium income and interest rate are found. By increasing government spending, the aggregate demand curves are shifted upward. The resulting IS2 is shifted outward. The money markets respond quickly, and a new point of equilibrium is reached at I2 and Y2. So by increasing government spending, the equilibrium level of national income has risen, and interest rate has also risen. That completes the video. Now you know how to find equilibrium in the goods and money markets, how to derive the aggregate demand curve based on that equilibrium, how the economy responds in the short run to a change in fiscal policy, such as increasing the money supply, or a change in monetary policy, such as increasing government spending. Thank you.